Hello, my name is Mark MacBayne. I'm the Practice Administrator for Hematology Oncology and Adult Bone Marrow Transplant at UCSF Medical Center. I'm here today to talk about how to become a heart surgeon. A heart surgeon is a physician who specializes in cardiothoracic surgery. As with any MD, you must start by first going to college. You will need to obtain a degree from a four-year college or university, typically majoring in science. This is not required, however, but if you choose not to major in a science, you must make sure that you take all of the science prerequisites for medical school, being 2 years of biology, 2 years of chemistry, a year of physics, and a year of calculus. Towards the end of your undergraduate career, you'll need to take what's known as the MCAT, or the Medical College Admissions Test. This is a standardized exam that is used by medical schools to evaluate a candidate's application for med school entrance. They use this along with your GPA. Medical school is highly competitive. In fact, less than a third of those who apply will actually be accepted on any given year. Therefore, it's very important to maintain a strong GPA and do well on the MCAT exam. Medical school itself is an additional four-year educational commitment, the first 2 years of which are typically reserved for didactic instruction in the health sciences, and the second 2 years are typically reserved for training in clinical skills. After completing your 4 years of medical school, you are an MD. However, you are not quite ready to be a heart surgeon. In order to become a surgeon, and in fact really any type of physician, you must complete what's known as a residency. Residency programs can vary in length, surgical residencies typically being longer. A surgical residency will be a minimum of 6 years, and for heart surgery will often be 8 years or more. This is formal training past your medical school education. During these years, you will learn first how to become a surgeon, and second, how to become a heart surgeon. After you've completed your residency in cardiothoracic surgery, many will go on to do a fellowship, which is an additional 1 to 2 years of additional postgraduate training. After completing all of your postgraduate training, you are ready to sit for the board exam as a cardiothoracic surgeon. And upon passing, you are a board certified cardiothoracic surgeon, ready to practice in the community. This is Mark MacBayne, Practice Administrator for Hematology Oncology at UCSF Medical Center.